The portfolio research on forecast cycles. You can scan the database looking for your own portfolios and or portfolios created by other users. It is possible to perform two types of searches. First, the default one when loading the portfolio page and your portfolios are shown. Then an advanced research filtering by one or more parameters. For example, one or more portfolio names, then in portfolio info section, one or more information on the portfolio, for example, the creator, you or other users, or both, the asset class of components, the number of years of backtest, and more. Then the portfolio statistics, one or more backtest statistics, such as at least 60% of the years closed in positive. Finally, the card fields is possible to customize the summary statistics of the cards and the metric for sorting the results. The results are always returned from the best to the worst according to a metric chosen by the user, you, and the default metric is based on the statistical significance of the portfolio returns. It is possible to perform following actions on each portfolio. If it belongs to another user, you can copy it and save it as yours, giving it a different name, because name must be unique in the entire website. While if the portfolio is yours, you can activate or deactivate alerts on Telegram to receive notification when an anomaly opens or closes a position. You can modify it, modify the name of the portfolio, anomalies that made it up. Which ones, how much each weights, and other things, and delete the portfolio. When you enter the portfolio page, the simple research is performed by default, so you can view the portfolios created by you, in this case the test portfolio I have just created. By clicking in the last icon, it opens a pop-up with the advanced search. The first section filters on portfolio's name. There are two search and select bars. In the first, you can choose the names of the portfolios you want to include in the search, while in the second one, the names of the portfolio you want to exclude from the search. The second section is filters on portfolio's info. There are portfolio author. You can choose me, all users, or all users excluding me, by choosing the first one is me by default, meaning myself, I, where you are the creator of such portfolios. Then everyone, all users, including your portfolios, or all users excluding you. Then there is direction, long, short, or both. So, for example, if you choose long, it will be returned just portfolios containing only long anomalies. Categories mode with categories. In this example, contains commodities, forex, and stock indices. We return portfolios that contains all these three categories, but can also contains other categories. Otherwise, if you choose contains only, it will be returned portfolios that contains only these three categories and not other ones. Here I selected the number of years 20, meaning I want portfolios whose anomaly has at least 20 years of history. Then there is number of trades all, given by the sum of all the trades of the components, number of trades 1 year, average number of trades, and average trade duration of a single trade in days. The third section, portfolio statistics, you can see statistics on yearly returns and statistics on monthly returns. Then there is a total return, total profit starting from a capital of 100, average return, standard deviation, reward risk, winning percentage, also here average return, reward risk, winning percentage, profit factor, stability of the equity line from 0 to 1, Sharpe ratio, Sortino ratio, average drawdown that measures how much the equity line has been near to the all-time highs during history, the maximum drawdown, and the conditional VaR. Then the excess block, so metrics measured on others, other in this case financial instruments. First one, the benchmark, S&P 500, with buy and hold strategies going long. And the second one, the risk-free US short-term bonds, 3 months. You can see here bench, meaning on benchmark, instead risk-free. Excess, so how much the portfolio exceeds the return of the S&P 500, winning excess winning percent on benchmark, excess winning percent of risk-free, excess average return on risk-free, excess reward risk on benchmark. Finally, the rating from 0 to 5, the index of statistical significance of the portfolio returns. Finally, there is the card fields section. You can choose the parameters to be shown in the cards of the results. Here, the left parameter, center, right parameters, and then order by parameter. Default is rating. The parameter to sort the results by. Then let's do some exercises on forecast cycle. The first one, simple search, but it's not an exercise, just a reminder. To perform the simple search, just enter the portfolios page and the simple search is automatically performed. That returns just your portfolios. First exercise, advanced search. We expand the search of the portfolios to all forecast cycles users, not just your own portfolios. Then we filter for direction, only portfolios that contains long anomalies, categories, portfolios that contains stock indices and maybe other asset classes. Then filter for anomalies with reward risk 1 year greater or equal than 0.35. Let's enter in the advanced filters by clicking the land button. Then go to portfolios info. Let's edit the creator from me to all users. The direction, only portfolios with long anomalies. Categories mode, contains, we want that contains at least a stock index. Then we filter for portfolios having at least 0.35 of reward risk. In the results you can see that every portfolio has a reward risk 1 year greater or equal than 0.35, and that each portfolio contains a stock index. You can see here the label SI bonds ETF, and each portfolio is green because it contains only long anomalies. Then we change the field of anomaly cards, putting the profit factor in place of average return 1 year, and we sort the results by average drawdown instead of by rating. We go back, card fields, instead of average return 1 year profit factor, and instead of rating we sort by average drawdown. Get results. Okay, we can see that here there is profit factor in the left side of the card, and that the portfolios are sorted by the average drawdown. Second exercise on templates. Let's save a template with name TPL test, refresh the page, load the template TPL test, and let's launch the portfolio search. So we go back here. You can see that there are other two buttons, load template and save template. Why template? If tomorrow we want to repeat the research, all the parameters we entered will be reset to default ones. So we can save our parameters by clicking save template, TPL test, add template, template successfully added. Then let's refresh the page, go back. Load template, template to insert TPL test, we can delete it if it's not useful anymore, apply it, you can see that category, stock indices and so on, get results, and we get the same results.